aspiring UKRN from Philippines, from Africa, from India, and other part of the world. As you all know, when you arrive here in UK, you will be a band for assistant practitioner, and then you need to pass your OSCE, and then you will be a band 5 staff nurse. So when you guys arrive here, there's a lot of trainings, even if you are not yet a band 5. They are mandatory trainings that are required by the trust or hospital that you will be working for. I don't know what other trusts require for the newly arrived international nurses, but things that I'm gonna say here in this video are my experience, are the trainings that I did during my assistant practitioner days before OSCE. Alright, okay, let's start. During my first few weeks here, they asked me to settle my accounts, like NHS mail account where you can read the updates from your hospital, and ESR account where you can see your payslips, me allocate where you can see your schedule and login details for the computer in the hospital. There's a website where you can see the trainings, where you can book your training, and you can also see your payslips there as well. So it is called esrnhs.uk. So this is the ESR. In this side, you can see the monthly payslips. For the first one, with the 2 at the end, that's the Carnoflex, that is my bank shift payslips. And on this side is your trainings, pay, personal information like that. So let's go to my learning. So you can search the trainings that you need to do, and course catalog, learning history, that my learning history. And down here, you can see that there are trainings that I haven't attempted, trainings that I passed. This one, supplemental oxygen therapy online, this is online training. This moving and handling assessment, that is face to face. Since there are a lot of special equipment to transfer patients, to handle patients, we need to do that training for the safety of ourselves, for our back, and for the safety of the patients. So I will show you guys the equipments that we use to transfer patients. We are using special equipment to transfer them, like SAR Steady, hoist, and I forgot. What else? The trainings that I did when I came here are mostly online, just like this one. Infection control, duty of condor, food safety awareness. This one is mandatory training. So in mandatory training, they will discuss blood transfusion, basic life support, equality and diversity, caring of end-of-life care patients. I can't remember the rest, but in one training, mandatory training, they discuss a lot of things. So when I do online training, there's assessment or examination at the end, and I need to pass that. So these trainings are like just fundamentals, basic questions, and it's easy to pass. Because if you failed it in your assessment, you can retry again, and the questions are like the same. There are online trainings that requires 100% score, and the questions and the choices are difficult. Yeah, you just need to like retry and retry. There are online trainings that requires only 5 attempts. So if you exceeded that 5 attempts, you are failed. So just be careful. There are trainings that not in ESR. It's in SITS Online, so it's another website. So in SITS Online, you can find the blood glucose monitoring, which every nurse should have access to, blood sugar machine, blood glucose. And also there's a training for taking observations. Observations is called vital signs in the Philippines. So before you can do observations or vital signs to your patients, you need to do the training. So that's another online training that you can find in SITS Online. There's also online training before you can access Maxims. So I mentioned that already in my previous vlog. It's down there. In Maxims, you can see the results of the blood tests, radiology tests of your patients. And you also, in Maxims, you can place order. If the patient needs urine sample, you just need to print a form by using Maxims. Another training that we can find in SITS Online is EPMA or JAC. I've mentioned that before as well in my previous vlog, where you can find the drugs or medications for your patients. We use EPMA during drug rounds. Without account, you can give medications to your patients. Without NHS mail, you can't see the login details. Without Maxims, you can't see the blood results, radiology results for your patients. So those accounts you need to have before passing exam. What I did before is, even if I'm not yet a band 5, I did all those trainings, and then when I passed the exam, I just rang the IT and they've updated my account, changed my name to RN. So the trainings that I did before I became a band 5 are blood glucose monitoring, mandatory training, which, and then the online trainings that I showed you guys earlier on the ESR site, observations training on SITS online, Maxims, and EPMA on SITS online. And yeah, mostly are online trainings that I did before I became a band 5. And let's go to POS OSCE or band 5 staff nurse trainings. So the first training that I did when I became a band 5 is supervised practice injectable medications workbook. There's a checklist inside. So anyone in your area that has been signed off can sign you off. So this injectable medications workbook includes the administrations of IV fluids, subcu medications, intramuscular medications, like that. Workbook for the NG tube, enteral feeding via fine bore feeding tube, NG tube. So I know even if we are 5 years qualified in our country, we still need to do these trainings. So there's also a checklist for checklist for insertion of NG tube, and also for administration of feed and medications. Yeah, all checklists for the catheterization, inserting catheter for male and female. So that's it. There's a workbook as well. Anyone in your area that has been signed off doing catheter, they can sign me off. It's also a checklist. I needed to do this one as well. There are trainings for machines like this. This one, T34 syringe driver. T34 syringe driver is used mainly for end-of-life care patients. Face-to-face training. And this one, Baxter pump is used for the IV fluid infusion, and also for the Alaris pump or infusion pump, Isoket infusion for the blood pressure control. Yeah, there's a lot of machines. For the NG tube feeding, there's a Mika pump or a feeding pump machine. In your area, they will require you to do this and that. So this one, injectable medications, and for the trainings of machines like Alaris pump, Baxter pump, T34, are commonly required for nurses. Intravenous cannulation workbook, there's also checklist inside. And I did, I think, 6 or 10 practice. So it says there that I pass. There's also workbook for venipuncture, which I did already, but I can't find the pack. I've done the cannulation, venipuncture, catheter, and all that. So if you are not trained, if you haven't done the face-to-face training and you haven't signed off, you are not allowed to do those cannulation, catheterization, bloods. So you need to do the trainings first. You will get in trouble. In my area stroke unit, they required us to do the tracheostomy training, so we can care for patients who's got tracheostomy, laryngectomy, like that. And also there's a training for blood transfusion. Like, I always put this in my bag. I don't know why I finished this already, but still in my bag. Blood transfusion. So it's in the mandatory training, which I've mentioned earlier. You just need to get a blood transfusion pack, and one of the staff nurses in your area can sign you if they are already signed off. You've done the assessment and practice. Your NHS badge, it will be activated so you can have access to blood bank. Yeah, so this is for the tracheostomy checklist. Oh, this is the venipuncture checklist, which I finished. And this one is for the swallow screen. since our patients are stroke, their swallow is impaired. Also banned for assistant practitioner can assess swallow. Those are the trainings that I did when I became a band 5. There are trainings that are not required in my area but are required in other area. So it depends. It depends. And that's it. I hope you guys learned something in this video. I managed to help you on what are the trainings that we need to do when we arrive here in UK before and after OSCE. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.